Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I'm the quantitative analyst at FXBootcamp.com, and this is your news alert for Friday, April 25th, 2008. Let me start by explaining that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. We do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer bootcamp members are trading on a demo account so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. In terms of economic news, tomorrow is more on the lighter side. For example, there are no major news events to speak of, U.S. major news events, I should say, during the New York session. However, there is one report during the European session worth watching, in my view. The U.K.'s Office for National Statistics will release their estimate of the country's GDP for the first quarter of this year. Now, the market's consensus estimate for this report tomorrow is a 0.4% rise in first quarter GDP for the United Kingdom. That would represent the lowest level of quarterly growth in 3 years for that country. Now, if the actual figure matches the estimate, then I would anticipate a rather muted initial reaction by the cable, after which I'd say the market's original inertia should take over, and the pair will probably continue to move, and I'd say probably a more technical fashion. However, if we do see a surprise from GDP number tomorrow, it can move the market. Looking back at the data over the past 27 months, as I see here in a NewsTrader Pro, we have seen 12 surprise outcomes. Those 12 surprises are noted by a differential of either positive or negative, shaded in either green or there in red. In each case, the difference between the expected GDP number and the actual GDP number was just 0.1%, either positive or negative. If we see a differential greater than 0.1%, either positive or negative tomorrow, then look out. That is a scenario that could really move the pound. But even a 0.1% differential can set us up for a nice news trade. Now, we got a 0.1% difference in January, which is, you see the graph here. The graph here is a 3-minute chart showing the response of the pound USD to January's report. And the pound did jump initially after the news release. You see here the 40 pip jump up after the better-than-expected GDP number. Unfortunately, the market was already buying the U.S. dollar on that particular day, and the jolt of the pound strength from the news simply did not last in an environment where the dollar was driving the market. So that was a bummer. It happens. Hey, in fact, be very careful. That same sort of thing could happen tomorrow if we get a GDP number of, say, 0.5%. Now, we did get two good news trade setups last fall, though. Looking back at November's release, let me switch that. The GDP number was worse than expected, minus 0.7% instead of the expected 0.8%, and the pound dropped about 55 pips in 3 minutes. If you got in on the candle I'm pointing to right now, the little red candle there, that the market was showing red after a touch of what appears to be in this vicinity right here, the 61.8% retracement of the original move down in response to the news. So when that candle shows you a little bit of red after reaching the 61.8% retracement, you might be in right there. And if you stood your ground while price tested in this ballpark up here, the 78.6% retracement level, then you held your trade through the next, say, hour or so, you netted up roughly a profit of 30 to 50 pips depending on your exit strategy. So, overall, when it's all said and done here, we had a 75 pip move down on the pound in response to the lower than expected GDP news. Now, switching to October, the month prior to that, let me switch to that. In October, we got a better-than-expected GDP number, and the pound rose 30 pips in the first 3 minutes. If you took your long trade after seeing shades of green at the 50% retracement, the 50% retracement level somewhere in here, you're in probably at the candle I'm pointing to right now, the little green candle there. If you took that entry and then rode this up for about 60 pips, you probably got out somewhere up in here, because at this level, you had a double top with the prior day's high. Notice this, by the way. The overall move here on this particular occasion was 75 pips up over 3 hours. The move I just showed you in November was 75 pips down. Interesting, huh? Okay, so given that the expected number for GDP is 0.4% tomorrow, here's what I'd like to see. I'd like to see some kind of difference, higher or lower. My preference would be for the news result to spark a move in line with what the market is already doing. If the dollar is weak tomorrow, then a GDP figure of 0.5% followed by British pound strength would be great. If the dollar is strong tomorrow, if we see some dollar strength tomorrow, which we've had over the past couple of days, if that strength continues tomorrow for the dollar, then a 0.3% GDP number would be nice. Let me be clear, though. Preferences are all fine and good, but I certainly cannot control the market. No one can, in fact. However, I can choose the situations where I trade, where I do trade, or I don't trade. Oh, one more thing. I'll finish with this. What I'm about to show you is a 4-hour chart for the British pound USD. Here we go. Now, do be aware, we have several sources of support over a 60 pip or so zone. From the psychological level at 9,600 up to this 2-month trend line and in between. So I'm talking about the zone in here. Got several sources of support in that particular zone. Again, the 2-month trend line, which I'm showing there in black, psychological level 9,600. There's two daily pivot points in that area and a weekly pivot point there as well. I believe it's the weekly M1. All of that could limit tomorrow's downside potential for the pound, assuming, of course, the pound even gets there. Okay, good trading, everyone. My name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your news alert for April 25th, 2008.